So now let's see how we can use the track 2 constraint inside of Blender. So here you can see that I have a shape, and to use the track 2 constraint, first of all, I'm going to go around and press Shift A on my keyboard to get the mesh menu. And then let's say, for example, I'm going to choose the cylinder. So I'm going to grab the cylinder over here and keep it on the top, let's say, for example. And what I want to do is I want to constrain this cube to the cylinder. So to do that, I'm going to select the cylinder right here, and then I'm going to go to the constraint, object constraint properties right over here. And then I'm going to go around and click on add object constraint. Once I do that, what you can do is you can choose track 2. And then once you go to track 2, you get to the target area. You can click on the eyedropper tool right here and click on object cylinder. And now what happens is that if you were to move the cylinder, you can see that this cube right here is constrained to that object. So wherever this faces, you can see that the cube faces that side. So if you were to go around right here, so you want something to be constantly facing some direction, you can do that. If you were to scale this out right here, just like this, scale it out from the side, what happens is that as I move this now, this is constrained to this particular object right here. You can also go around and change the track axis if you want to. You can change the up and rotate the object as per what you like as well, and change around other things. So now what else you can do is you can go around and then choose add in another constraint as well. So I'm going to go around and press Shift A on my keyboard, and then I'm going to add in an empty plane axis constraint. So let me just drag this up right here, and then I'm going to select this cylinder, and then I'm going to go around over here, add the object constraint, and then I'm going to click on track 2. Once I do that, I'm going to select this empty object right here, and now the cylinder has been constrained to this particular area. So if I were to move this out, you can see that the cylinder moves as well as the cubicle moves just like that. And that is how you can use the track to constraint option inside of Blender. So hope you guys learned something as always. And as always, please like, comment, share, and subscribe.